Welcome to Paul's News on the Go, brought to you by
ADB, truly a Greek and more.
President John Mahama has lauded the role of the Electoral Commission in bringing out processes to ensure free and fair credible polls this November 7. Presented the State of the Nation's address on Thursday, he said Ghana's EC has received commendation from across the world for successes it has chalked over the years in the country's electoral process. In education, the president said 54,800 children in four regions have been enrolled into schools under free education. Under health, President Mahama said a team of technical experts have been set up to propose fundamental reforms that will revive the national health insurance scheme. President John Mahama has hit hard at a central bank for sleeping on the job while some microfinance companies milk unsuspecting customers of their life earnings. According to him, the Bank of Ghana has to be blamed for the rather callous manner in which many households have had their livelihood tampered with. The Managing Director of DKM Microfinance, Dr. Martin Delle, and three others are standing trial for fraudulent breach of trust. Meanwhile, the acting chairman of the opposition New Patriotic Party, Freddie Blay, has described the State of Nations address delivered by President John Mahama as disappointing. He said Mahama touting roads as achievement is a sign of mediocrity. Officials of the Police Intelligence and Professional Standards Unit have apprehended two constables for allegedly extorting monies from unsuspecting members of the public, most of them drivers at Tabora Junction. The arrested policemen are Constable Musa Azuma, who purportedly posed as an inspector, and Constable Faati Tinob Jacob, stationed at the Police Visibility Unit of the National Patrols Department. Preliminary investigations revealed that Constable Musa Azuma was not an inspector, as his uniform suggested. When a search was conducted on the two, it was discovered that Constable Musa Azuma had an amount of 82 cedis and two Gota brand service radio sets on him, while Constable Faati Tinob also had an amount of 165 cedis on him.
And that was your Paul's News on the Go, brought to you by
ADB. More.